Welcome my dear student to the new topic. As in the last video we discussed the direct memory access point, and now here in this video we have to discuss the very important topic, that is the bus arbitrations. Now for discussing the bus arbitration, first we are to be well known or very well known about the bus. What is meant by a bus? Normally for to transfer the data from one place to another, from one device to another device, we are using a certain methodology, we are using a certain hardware part which is called as a bus. By using that, we can send the data, we can send the address, or we can send the control information to one place to another place, that we can that you already know. But if you go in the details of that bus and bus structure, so we found that there are certain different things, like a processor or the main memory or the IO devices are to be interconnected by using a certain device which is called as a bus. This bus provide a communication path for the transfer of data. It also include the line to support the interrupt as well as to support arbitrations also. So for that purpose we are trying to discuss the arbitration, but before trying to discuss the bus arbitration, we are to be well known about a bus. So for that purpose we will try to discuss the bus. Bus protocol is a set of the rules that govern the behavior of various devices that connected to the bus. As two, when place information on the bus, when assert the control signals. Normally this bus line may be grouped into the some of the types, like a data bus, control bus, address bus. If we are using a certain bus, and by using a bus we are only sending a data from one device to another device, then it is called the data bus. In the same way, if you are using bus for to send the address from one device to another device, then it is called as an address bus. And similarly, if you are using a same bus for sending a data from one device to another device, for sending a control signal from one place to another place, then again it is called as a control bus. So now this is called a control lines or control bus. Okay, so control signal specify the certain operation, that whether it is to be read, whether to be write, or what is the size of that particular data that we are trying to send, whether it is in the form of byte, bit, or it is in the form of long word or words. So and also it gives you the, it specify also the timing information to indicate that when the processor and IO devices may get place the data or may get receive the data from the bus. There is a scheme for the timing of data transfer over a bus can be classified into two different parts, like synchronous or asynchronous. There are different ways that we again try to discuss in terms of the processor bus. Here we have to see the important topic, that is the bus arbitration. That was very important. Now what happens, that the device that is allowed to initiate the data transfer on the bus is called as a bus master. Clearly, only one bus master can exist at any given time. So when the master gives up its control, other devices can acquire this status. Normally, it is called as. So this bus arbitration is the process by which the next device to become the bus master and select the bus and bus mastership transfer it. The selection of the bus master must take in the account the needs of various devices by establishing the priority system for gaining the access to the bus. There are the two approaches to a bus arbitration that we are trying to discuss in previous one, that the processor and a DMA controller both need to initiate a data transfer on the bus, and it has to be access the main memory. The device that is allowed to initiate the transfer on the bus at any given time is called as bus master. When the current bus master relinquish its status as a bus master, another device can acquire status. Normally, the processor by which the next device to become the bus master is selected and bus mastership is to be transferred to its call is a bus arbitration. There are two types of arbitrations. One is the centralized arbitrations and another is the distributed arbitration. There is a difference between centralized and a distributed arbitration. In a centralized arbitration, a single bus arbiter performs the arbitration, whereas in a distributed arbitration, all the devices participate in the selection of the next bus master. We will see one by one. First is the centralized bus arbitration. Here, the block diagram of the centralized bus arbitration will be in front of you. Here you can observe that there is one processor block, and through that processor block, two DMA controller is to be connected in series. That is DMA controller 1 and DMA controller 2, and that two DMA controller are to be connected in a series manner. The bus arbitrator may be the processor or a separate unit connected to a bus, which shows in this diagram that a basic arrangement in which the processor contains the bus arbitration circuitry. In this case, the processor is normally the bus master unless it grants a membership to one of the DMA controller. Until it cannot allow another one, the processor is only a master controller. A DMA controller indicates that it needs to become the bus master by activating the bus request line. That is BR bar. The signal on the bus request line is the logical OR of the bus request from all the devices connected to it. And when the bus request is activated, the processor activates the bus grant signal, that is BG1, indicating to the DMA controller that they may use the bus when it becomes the free. In terms of the centralized bus arbitration, the bus arbitrator may be the processor or the separate unit that connected to the bus, and normally the processor is the bus master unless it grants a bus membership to one of the DMA controller, and that DMA controller requests the control of the bus by asserting the bus request, that is BR line. In the response of that, the processor activates the bus grant, that is BG1. If you can observe this one, this is called as a bus grant, BG1. BG1, BG2, that is bus grant 1, bus grant 2. Signal. That indicates that the controller may use the bus when it is free. That BG1 signals is to be connected to the all DMA controller in a Disney chain fashion and in series manner. And there is a BBSY signals is to be 0. It indicates that the bus is BB. Bus is busy. When BBSY becomes 1, that the DMA controller which asserted the BR can acquire the control of the bus. The signal is connected to all the DMA controller using a Disney chain arrangement. Thus, if the DMA controller is 1 requesting the bus, the block proportion of the signal to the other device. Otherwise, it passes the grant downstream by asserting BG2. The current bus master indicates to all devices that it is using the bus by activating the another open controller line, which is called as the busy bus, that is BBSY bar. And hence, after receiving the bus grant signal, the direct memory access controller, it waits for the bus busy to become inactivate and then assume the mastership of the bus. At this time, it activates the bus busy to prevent the other devices from using the bus at the same time. In this way, this centralized memory access will get work. In next video, we'll try to discuss the distributed arbitration and how it different with a centralized arbitration. That in all that one also we can see in the next video. So thank you.